Hey guys, welcome back to the second time lucky mining channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at Flux nodes and specifically which VPS providers are the better ones to use specifically for Cumulus nodes. If you do like the Flux content, please smash the like button and maybe consider subscribing to the channel. It will help me out a great deal. But let's jump into the content. Now that you've clicked on the video, I assume you already know what Flux is and what the project is trying to achieve. Thus, I'll focus my attention on the different VPS providers that you could use potentially to support the network and stand up some nodes. Before we jump into the different VPS options, I'd like to tackle the elephant in the room, which is decentralization. And that's really what Flux is about and what cryptocurrency is about. So you should really look at standing up your own hardware. And for that, there are various different options, such as Raspberry Pis, which I've done, and I'll leave a link in the video description and tag it at the top, Nvidia Jetsons, using a gaming computer, a laptop, or dedicated hardware. If some of those reasons really doesn't work, specifically like in my case, the internet speed, that's really when you should be looking at these different VPS options. By the way, I've recently joined the Zzz Money Club, started by your friend Andy and Colin the Decade Investor. It's really a Discord community of like-minded individuals working towards achieving their goals. There's a ton of crypto content in there and people like me helping each other to achieve their goals. If you consider joining, I'll leave a link in the video description. Now back to the different VPS options. Now some of you might know, and I'll leave a link in the video description and tag it at the top, but I used to run a Raspberry Pi on the Flux network. But due to my networking and internet issues, I decided to go down the VPS route. Now for that, I currently run 9 Cumulus nodes across 4 VPS providers. However, I've tested 2 more which I subsequently cancelled. And that's what the video is really about. I'd like to share my opinions on these different VPS providers to help you make a decision at the end of the day. Because what worked for me might not necessarily work for you, and you need to make your own decisions. And content like this hopefully would help you make that decision. Now let's jump on the computer and have a look at the 6 different VPS providers that I have tested. Okay, so here we are on the computer. Now, before we look at the list that I'm using, what you should be looking at as a base is the official list that Flux puts out. Now, where you find that is if you go to the Run on Flux webpage, you select this Launch Nodes option and then Flux Node Renting options. So what you'll find here is an Excel that the Flux team update with the various different options that they would recommend with some comments across the different tiers. So you can see here Cumulus, Nimbus and Stratus. So where I've been playing around, and it's just because I don't have enough Flux, but I've only been using the Cumulus tab here. Now for that, you can see here is a couple of providers in this list. So Kimisufi, so you start, Netcups, Hostnodes, and Advent Service. So some of the options that I'm using is obviously not on this list. So the two that I haven't tested with is the two at the top due to the prices, and I really haven't had a look at Advent Service. So I probably should be looking at that, but I can see here is a orange marking around some of the issues that they currently have. Okay, so now let's have a look at the VPS providers that I actually have been using. Now for that, I'm going to go to my Google Sheet. And by the way, I'll leave a link in the video description, but it's also on my YouTube channel and should also be on my Twitter account. But in here, I've got a specific tab that looks at Flux VPS options. Here you can see across my 9 Flux nodes, which are the VPS providers that I'm currently using. And then what is the specifications, product name, the actual amount that I'm paying, and this includes tax, the benchmark performance that I get from them, and the amount of weekly failures. By the way, if you haven't watched my how to set up a Flux watchdog, I'll highly encourage it, and I'll leave a link in the video description and tag it at the top. But it will let you know in case there are any issues with your actual node. The different payment options, and then where I could, what actual hardware they are using to run on the specific VPS providers. Now the first VPS provider in my list is Contabo, and as you can see, I currently run 3 nodes of Contabo. And if you have a keen eye, you would notice that Contabo is no longer in the recommended list. And that's because they fail the DWS score every now and again. And as you can see here, I've marked them in red.
Now, what happens is that every now and again, their SSD speeds drops below the minimum benchmarks, and then you subsequently fail benchmarks. Now, what will happen specifically in Flux is, I'm not sure exactly how frequently do they run these benchmarks, but you know, in my experience, it's probably about every half an hour they run the benchmarks and have a look if you failed. Now, generally, if you fail, you can have, I think it's up to 100 blocks, so that's about 200 minutes to fix the issue. Now, generally speaking, what happens is Flux's DWS score eventually gets up within the 100 blocks, and then you pass the benchmarks. And that's what something that I've seen consistently. But if I was new and starting over, I probably wouldn't use Contabo, to be honest, to deal with this every now and again benchmarking issue. So it's really not specifically worth the trouble. And if you look at the cost here, it's sort of you know, on the higher side of what currently I'm paying for. And as such, you know, I'm not really looking to add more Contabo servers. Now, the next one in my list is Netcups. And as you can see, I currently rock two nodes specifically on Netcups. And looking at their benchmarks, I currently get a decent EPS score, obviously not as good as the Contabo ones, but I think Contabo is rocking the new AMD Epic chips. But their DWS score is actually quite good. And I really haven't had any of my nodes failing a benchmark since I've got them, to be honest. And that's really what I value. It's not necessarily what the one time or every 30 minutes benchmark score is how consistently can you hit these benchmarks. And that's really what you look for in a VPS provider. And in my case, at least in my opinion, Netcups is actually quite good in that specific space. The next one in the list is iHostart, and you would have noticed that they're currently not on the Flux list. They were added at some point, but then due to all of the issues that we had, they were subsequently removed. Now, some of those issues has been resolved, or all of those issues actually has been resolved. I think the first one was the RAM being an issue. So what happened was the service sort of ran out of RAM and restarted. They fixed that. The next issue that we had was around the EPS score, so the CPU score, which they also failed and subsequently fixed. I actually quite like the owner. He was in Discord facing the music for angry people like myself not being able to stand up the nodes. But you know, since they've had those issues, they've actually all but fixed all of them. Now, if you look at the consistency perspective, you can see here they're actually more consistent than my Contabo service. So as I mentioned, Contabo fails every single day. The DWS score across all of the nodes that I actually have. And if you compare that to iHostart, not only are they cheaper, but the one server that I've had never had any issue, the other one only had one issue for the whole week. So they are a little bit more consistent and cheaper than what I can get here from Contabo. Now, the last one on the list that I'm actually using is Hostnodes. And from a EPS and DWS perspective, they actually benchmark quite well, but from a reliability perspective, I actually don't know if they are up a lot. And the reason for that is just the way that the platform operates. You can't really connect into the actual VPS and install or see some of the watchdog results. So that's really why it's sort of gray here with a question mark, just because I can't get in there. But from a raw benchmark perspective, it actually quite looks good. Now, the last two on the list here that I'm actually not using, that I've actually used or tested at least before, is Hetzner and SSD Nodes or Strashmore. Now, for Hetzner, they're actually quite good. They operate more or less the same as Contabo or Netcups around the service that they provide. And a lot of the current community is actually using Hetzner. So there's really nothing wrong with Hetzner. It's just there was an extra step that I needed to do that I wasn't keen for, and then I subsequently cancelled and went with Contabo. So there wasn't any benchmarking issues at all. SSD Nodes or Strashmore, however, I failed a lot of benchmarks, and then I subsequently cancelled and went with Netcups at that specific point in time. So I definitely don't recommend SSD Nodes or Strashmore. I really only had issues there. Now, in conclusion, which VPS Cumulus providers would I recommend? Now, it really depends on your situation and what you would want to do, but at least for me, Hostnodes is a great option, not only from a decentralization perspective, so you're not going with this massive company, it's an actual community member standing up these nodes. They actually run these nodes for you. So from a simplistic point of view, if you're not interested in learning Linux or any of these commands or anything like that, you know, at the end of the day, you just take your coins, you provide them the details, you send over your Flux to pay, And they will run the node for you. So from a simplicity point of view, it's really easy. And then it's a hell of a decentralized as well. So, you know, that would be one of the options that I would recommend. If you're more interested in tinkering and playing and learning Linux and stuff like that, the second option that I would definitely say is Netcups. You know, not only from a performance perspective, they are great, but they also hell of a consistent. And that's what I look for from a VPS provider. And then on the cost side, as I mentioned, they sort of, you know, in the middle from a cost perspective, at least in my list. If you are looking for something a little bit more cheaper and you're willing to give iHostart a shot, they are keen to sort of work with Flux at the end of the day. So I'll definitely mention them as well.
That's it for this video, guys. If you've liked the video, please like it and consider subscribing to the channel. If you didn't like it, please specify in the comments what you would like me to change. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.